I got a fellow who walked in here. He said that y'all sound like you're having too much fun inside of there. And he says we are all one family, so he wants to say hello. Robert Nelson, good morning.
Oh, good morning. Good morning. How are you,
Doc? I'm hanging out with these fellas here. I'm hanging out with the Titans here in studio. Pelham, Goddard, Leston, Paul, and Peter Blood. It's good to hear you, my brother. We were talking about Soca.
Hey, Peter Blood.
Hey, Nello.
Alafia. Hello.
Hello.
That's my brother from way back. We know where we're coming from, baby.
Yeah. You see what I'm saying? You notice he went straight to Smokey and Bundy. He went straight. Robert, don't start trouble.
You remember Lala one take in the studio?
Remember Lala? Yeah, I remember all that other stuff, but I'm going to start with Lala. That's what you want to do.
Yeah, I was on that record.
Let's talk about that whole question, because I know you have some strong opinions on that Soca area, Robert Nelson, Lord Nelson. My brother, in that era, we have heard identified a number of people. We heard the actual story of what happened at the penthouse, what happened down in KH Studio. We heard about the Watson. We heard about all the contributors. You had a different take on that?
Let me tell you something about that. I know the truth.
Uh-huh.
But tell like always, that's the same record you play all the time, Foreigner.
You
label that.
Yes, yeah, I remember
you
Foreigner.
I play it almost every morning when I lay down and I feel it, I want to cry. Mm. Nobody knows the real trouble I see. I know the truth about that. Same thing.
Well, give me the truth. Give me your version of that, Robert.
Let me tell you something. I was in Tobago with Lord Shorty Eye. And we sat up by a table before going on stage. This is the truth. This ain't no lie. And I'm talking to Shorty, and I'm saying, well, listen, we're going to get together, man. He's answering me, say, we're going to try and make this thing go abroad. Him and I, and God bless his soul, the boy maestro. The man was singing Endless Vibration. I was doing Disco Daddy. We all were singing a little different to the regular Calypso thing.
Mm. You were both looking for a different direction, a different way to export.
Maestro. The next thing you know, we up there. They say my music is too much soul and Yankee thing. You hear this thing, soul.
Foreigner, yes.
You understand?
Mm-hmm.
Calypso. Soul, Calypso. Tim and I sat up by the table. Say, we go short this thing and make it Soca. That's where Soca come from in that name. Up to this blessed day, nobody can put it together. They turn it around until you get to be groovy Soca. I don't know what it is. God bless a man, a genius. You hear me? That used to arrange for Vespers. You see me, Clive Bradley. I cannot play no instrument. You listen to me good. I used to make the whole bass, if you listen to it, it's almost like a tune. Before I compose, they say, Duke composed these things for me. If Duke composed that, how come you don't sing it for yourself? How could Duke do King Liar? Oh, my God Almighty. When I come back from New York the next day, they say, Shorty, I invented a thing named Soca. Up to now, nobody cannot do it. It between that man, me, and Clive Bradley.
But, you know, Robert, you will agree that there is no exact way to tie down music, one. Two, and the other thing is, we're all in agreement here because the central point made by Pelham and by Leston via conversation is that you had many contributors of different areas of the sound we now know as soca. So we are not at variance here.
All right.
All right, now
agree with that.
Now you're a man. You have exported this music all over the world. I'm gonna thank you for joining us, but I'm gonna ask you this one question: where are we heading to? And you kind of pushed me into doing a little quantum leap. Where are we heading to is where the art form is right now. As one who has done the export, I know you may not do the circuit as much as you used to. Are you comfortable with what you're hearing now, which is I remember when you were doing your music and other people doing music, folks go like, no, what is that they're doing? So every new generation is condemned by the generation before them. What is your view of where the art form is right now? Are you comfortable with the experiments, even if you don't agree with it? Are you comfortable with the direction to say this will take us into the next century and expose us across the world?
The problem is with that, I see time changes. And I guess the music changed to what it is. But I just can't explain to anyone what it is or where it's going. So I just sit back and listen and say, hey, we were just roots.
Give the direction a chance.
What's happening now? That's all I could see. When you hear Marshall Montano,
yes,
with what's going on there, if he played the tape back, I'm the first one that took him abroad to Paris, put him on my shoulder when he was singing Too Young to Soca. You remember that?
I remember him Too Young to Soca.
I'm listening to what's happening now. I say, well, this is what's happening. It's the young group. It's the young session. And I'm back there listening to it and say, well, anyway, I'm part of whatever is going on. But I can't put a handle on it to tell you the truth. It's good.
Well, I tell you what, my brother, the good thing about it is that we can just watch it change the way the others who preceded us had to watch it change. Watch it. And then I've got to take you back to the studio for you to sing that song that you did on the spot. Robert Nelson, thank you so much for joining me, my brother.
And God bless you, too. Thank you, everybody. Hey. In the studio with you. God bless.
All right. Thank you so much, man.